What's up, guys? Pastor Rob here with Gage, my son.
Hello.
Back with another reaction video. Today we have a special request. This one I've seen in the comment section several times. Also happens to be my son's favorite band.
Mm-hmm. Opeth.
The band Opeth. Mm-hmm. We're going to be doing a song called...
Deliverance.
Deliverance from the double album on vinyl.
Deliverance and Damnation.
Deliverance and Damnation. Now, I guess I've heard some of the stuff from which album?
Damnation.
Okay, mm-hmm. Damnation. Mm-hmm. All right, and this is Deliverance. So is this part of a concept album? Is it like telling the whole story?
Not necessarily, to my knowledge. But it seems to me that some of the songs are connected like content-wise.
Okay.
Meaning that they kind of deal with similar topics.
Similar themes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Now, why is it packaged as a double album?
Well, interestingly, when they were first released, it wasn't a double album. It was intended to be a double album, but the record label convinced them to release the two albums separately for proper promotion.
Hmm.
But this re-release was packaged the way it was intended to be, as a double album.
That's what I'm talking about. Intended to be.
Mm-hmm. The reason they wanted it to be a double album was because one is soft and mellow, and one is very heavy.
So which one's the heavy one?
Deliverance.
And which one's the one I heard?
Damnation.
Okay. So Damnation is the soft one.
Mm-hmm.
And Deliverance is the heavy one.
Yeah.
That is so confusing to me. You think it'd be the other way around. So I can see here. Damnation, the song Windowpane. I'm familiar with that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the names of the rest of them, but definitely know I've heard Windowpane, which I think is a beautiful song.
Mm-hmm. That was the song that got me into them.
Well, yeah, and thankfully, interesting story here. I don't know if Gage remembers this, but I didn't know he was listening to this band. And actually, this was kind of the inspiration of me taking another look at music and lyrics and kind of looking at it without the typical Christian prejudice. I wanted to look at the lyrics for what they were, because I had seen this album on the computer, and I saw Damnation. And obviously, pastor's like, oh no, my son's listening to an album called Damnation, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I nervously clicked the first song, and it was Windowpane. And I was like, man, this is pretty good.
Yeah.
So I read all the lyrics in the album, learned a little bit about the band, and I was grateful for what I had learned. So I'm excited to hear this song, actually. So you're saying this is the heavier stuff.
Yeah, and when I first heard the heavier stuff after hearing Windowpane, I was honestly pretty disappointed, because stuff like Windowpane, that sort of mellower music is what I was really into at the time, and I did not like metal really that much, or at least this style of metal. So as I explored some more of their music, I actually ended up growing to like it, and it ended up expanding my style.
So am I gonna like it?
I guess we'll see.
Well, I know I like the softer stuff, so I don't know what you mean when you say heavy, so we'll see. Is there anything I need to know about this song as we go into it?
So the song Deliverance was inspired by an event that had happened to guitarist Peter's girlfriend and some of her friends. They were like at a party or something, and some guy held them hostage and took them to his apartment. He started cutting himself in front of them and threatening to kill himself.
What?
Yeah.
So he held them hostage while cutting himself?
Mm-hmm.
So that inspired this song.
Yeah.
Deliverance.
Yeah, that kind of element and theme of lunacy basically inspired this song.
Huh. Interesting. I'm excited. So we have the lyrics right here on the, what do you call this thing, a sleeve?
Mm-hmm.
So I'll be reading along this way. As always, I'm going to listen to the song objectively. I haven't read the lyrics, so I don't even know what we're about to get into. And we'll maybe discuss it after the song's over.
All right.
Deal? You ready?
Yeah. Let's go.
You can start buttons on your side.
But yeah,
expecting that. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Huh. They're goosebumps.
Already?
Yeah.
Well, expect some more.
Now, that's the Opeth I know.
Yeah. It's crazy how they can combine that, right?
And that sounds so clean. It's recorded so well.
Oh, by the way, this is the remixed version, and I've not heard it yet. I just recently got this vinyl.
Yeah. First part, I wasn't sure. Oh, yeah.
Here we go.
See? Look at that. Double. Both arms.
That effect is a lot more clear on the remix. And the delay. how he carries that last note under the neck line. I watched the documentary about the production of the two albums.
Yeah?
Pretty interesting.
Hmm. I'll check it out. Salvation is found in sinners' deed.
I'm not entirely sure what he means by that.
Interesting.
Do you have any guesses?
No. I'm having trouble following. So far, it sounds like there's a conversation between two different people.
Oh, yeah. I know what part's coming next.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's been a while since I've listened. A lot of people wondered what we would think about these lyrics when they click the video. The devil guides the way. You know, as a Christian, I've never really liked hearing that, but it really fits into the theme of the song, like the insanity and like the kind of murder that he's committing.
That makes sense. Yeah, absolutely. Devil's guiding the way.
Yeah.
Curious about your salvation's found in a sinner's deed.
Yeah, that's one I've never really been able to make sense.
Y'all gonna have to help us out with this one.
Oh yeah. I love that lead guitar here. How it leads into this bar? Yeah.
Yes. That's the stuff I like. Hmm. It's recorded so beautifully. Must be the remastered version is clean.
Even the original is clean.
I've never heard of it.
It was recorded and produced by Stephen Wilson. He's a pretty professional dude.
Nice. Love that. His headphones are like awesome too, to be honest. From inside of my head.
This is my favorite part. Oh yeah.
Nice. Ah, you boys are talented.
Accents on this part. It's very weird. It took me forever to figure out how to headbang to it.
I know, I'm just like, I'm stuck in it.
Yeah.
Gets his head banging. Man. It's a little distortion, you hear that?
Yeah. I think that's the vinyl. Or the remaster.
Needle might be a little dirty. don't know how they stayed in time.
Yeah.
How they get such a sharp, like something cutting off the sound in between, like a gate.
Yeah, I think they're using some pretty heavy noise gate, I imagine. Especially with this bus distortion. Probably some compression too.
It's amazing, it's so long, but it's been good the entire time.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, the growling stuff is a little off for me, but it makes sense in the context. And he's good at it.
Yeah, he is.
I like that. Cool ending.
Yeah.
Those dudes are supremely talented.
Mm-hmm.
There's no doubt. The versatility in the vocals baffles me. I don't understand how somebody with such a beautiful voice can also go to that sort of growly thing.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
And it is like, I don't know, I've only heard a couple growly songs, but it's like sounds like it's coming from way down here somewhere. Mm-hmm. Am I right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it sounds pretty deep.
It's, I don't know. It makes my makes me want to clear my throat. Wow, well, I like the song.
Yeah, it was a great song.
Yeah, you know, I got a little nervous. I'll be honest, when we first started singing like that, I was like, ooh. Mm-hmm. but then they brought in all the elements and, like I said, showed their diversity.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's amazing. As far as the song's meaning goes, I am absolutely confused.
Well, it seems to me that it's about, well, a murderer, but more specifically, it seems to be that he's drowning someone.
Okay.
Face
down beneath the waterline, gazing into the deep.
Mm-hmm. And there's another part that kind of communicated that to me, like where he says, walk with me.
Mm-hmm.
You'll never leave. Wait to see your spirit free. Tell me how your heart's in need as I drown you in the sea.
Hmm. So do you think, was that the growly voice saying that?
That was in the clean part. The part after the intro.
See, at first I started, it seemed to me that there was sort of like this conversation happening. Maybe that's the lunacy thing. Maybe there's this rational, irrational thing going on, but it sounds like they were both sort of had the same motive. I'm looking forward to seeing the comments because have you read anything about the song? Is there anything that you've read?
Not really, besides the inspiration for it coming from the incident that happened to Peter's girlfriend.
Mm. So outside of that, there's nothing...
Yeah,
really
not
to
really.
To know about the song. So help us out. Help us figure out. We're curious about your salvation's found in a sinner's deed,
mm-hmm.
what that could mean. And obviously the devil guides the way, tells me what to say, pours himself inside, and snuffs the final light. I mean, that makes sense. I could see that as the light, you know, the light of, obviously in the Bible, the light is attributed to the gospel, to truth.
Mm-hmm.
And so the little bit of sanity he has left is snuffed out mm-hmm. by the devil, and then he does the thing that he was setting out to do.
Yeah.
Also the line, deliverance laughing at me. So to be delivered from something means to be rescued from,
mm-hmm.
right? And biblically, we are rescued from the punishment of sin, We are delivered from that because of the death of Jesus, right?
Yeah.
But he's saying deliverance is laughing at him. So the rescue is laughing at him as if...
As if he can't be saved.
Yeah, as if the thing he can't be saved, I'm assuming from the situation he's in.
Mm. There is a theory I have about this song. I've always felt as if it was connected to the next song on the album, A Fair Judgment.
Mm.
If you... should we do a reaction to that song? I don't know. Well, my theory is basically that the two songs are connected. I think I shared this to you on Christmas. This one's Fair Judgment, about like awaiting punishment. So I've always felt that like after the main character like commits the murder, he receives a judgment or something like
so
that.
So losing sleep, in too deep, fading sun, what have I done? Come so close to what I need most, nothing left here. Mm. Cutting the ties, uncover disguise, left behind, all intertwined, lost control, moved out of the role, now nothing's left here. Leave it be, it was meant for me, soul sacrifice, forgot the advice, lost track of time in a flurry of smoke, a waiting anxiety for a fair judgment deserved. Ah, I see what you mean. So maybe this is the remorse after he commits the crime?
Yeah, that's always what I've thought.
Interesting. I can see that. He's losing sleep. He's realized what he's done. He's experienced remorse. It says that he has a waiting anxiety. So he's anxious while he's waiting for a fair judgment that's deserved.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I like your theory. Will you guys post your theories down in the comments? Help us understand the deliverance song. Enjoyed the song. Would love to comment more on its contents, but it's baffling me. And a fair judgment as well. Confirm Gage's theory or give us your theory. We'd appreciate that.
Yeah, maybe we'll even do a reaction to that one eventually.
Yeah, I'd like to hear it. Now I'm interested. So we're going to have to do that. So, please like, subscribe, comment. Thank you guys for all the encouragement that you've given us so far. And thank you for enjoying the channel. Share with your friends. And let us know what other songs from Opeth you'd like us to do a reaction to down in the comment section. We'll see you on the next video.
Peace.